Hello, this is Dr. Jawad. Please subscribe to my channel for more up-to-date videos, and thanks for watching. Hello everyone, this is Dr. Jawad. In this short video, I'm gonna give you 10 symptoms in no particular order that you may be low in vitamin D. Now, vitamin D is a phenomenal vitamin. It's not even a vitamin. Vitamin D is actually a pro-hormone, which basically it's a precursor for hormones like testosterone, like estrogens, like progesterone. It's phenomenal, works with cholesterol to be an anti-inflammatory. It's great for the brain. It's great for your gut. It's great for bones. And the thing about vitamin D, it's a fat-soluble vitamin along with vitamins A, D, E, and K. So you need good gut function for better absorption of vitamin D. Now, I don't promote any particular brands because a lot of people always ask me, what brand do I use? What brand do I recommend? Right? I always say, do your research. Look around, find a high quality brand and go with it. Right now I'm using vitamin D3 from Sports Research, and it's laced with coconut oil for better absorption. So do your homework, find out what brand is good for you, because I get a lot of questions asked. I don't promote any brand in particular. So 10 signs, no particular order, that you may be low in vitamin D. Now, just one caveat. When I work with my patients, I want my vitamin D levels to be the highest possible. So healthy levels, anything above 50 nanograms per deciliter. So a minimal 50. A lot of times the medical doctors, they're looking at 30. I always want at least 50, 60, 70 and above is perfect, okay? So 10 signs in no particular order. So number one, muscle and bone weakness. Vitamin D maintains bone mineralization. Bones are made of from calcium and phosphorus, and you need vitamin D to help absorb it, help absorb those. Two, you feel sad. Vitamin D is a phenomenal mood stabilizer. It's good for the brain. It helps regulate the brain firing pattern with the emotional components. So if you're low in vitamin D, this is why you may feel sad all the time. Chronic gum disease. Vitamin D is amazing. It reduces the pathogenic bacteria in the mouth. The mouth is full of bacteria, and if you're low in vitamin D, this may be one of the reasons why you have chronic gum disease. Four, you have high blood pressure. Now, research has proven that low vitamin D levels are linked up to high blood pressure. So having high blood pressure and low vitamin D levels may be the reason. You're tired all the time. Low vitamin D levels are associated with fatigue and sleep disorders. It's good for the brain. It's good for mood. Now, I always suggest one thing. When you're taking vitamin D as a supplement, take it first thing in the morning because it can interfere with your sleep pattern. Okay, but if you're low in vitamin D, this is one of the reasons why you may be tired and fatigued. You experience mood swings. Vitamin D affects the amount of serotonin production in our brain. We love two things, dopamine, serotonin, GABA, and glutamate. Serotonin makes us feel good. So if we have low vitamin D levels, this is why you may be having mood swings. You're overweight. Why? Because body fat cells absorb vitamin D quickly and remove it from the blood. So if you're low in vitamin D, this is one of the reasons why you have a hard time with weight loss, because also vitamin D helps with the insulin levels. You have gut issues. Now, this is very important because vitamin D3 is a fat-soluble vitamin. So you need a good gut to absorb the fat-soluble vitamin. So GI trouble can cause low absorption of the fat-soluble vitamin, vitamin D3. So I always suggest fix your gut to help absorb these fat-soluble vitamins. If you help absorb these fat-soluble vitamins, you're going to be doing better overall. You have allergies. Now, again, vitamin D3 is a phenomenal anti-inflammatory. Okay, so what is allergies? Allergies creates an inflammatory response in your body. If you're low in vitamin D, you don't have any immune system. Also too, constant respiratory problems. Constant respiratory problems, low vitamin D, especially with patients that I deal with who have asthma. Okay, now if you have chronic respiratory problems, if you're an asthmatic with low vitamin D, what happens? You can't take a deep breath. And what happens if you can't take a deep breath? Then you're gonna have anxiety issues. So I treat a lot of my patients with anxiety and respiratory problems like asthma or just COPD by upping their vitamin D levels, and it helps them a lot. So 10 symptoms just off the top of my head of why you may have of vitamin D deficiency. Get it, use it, and I'll see you in the next video. Thanks for watching.